This is the solution to written homework 54. So we want to find the critical points. To remind you, there's two kinds of critical points, two varieties. One is the variety when you have a surface that has something like a pointy place, so something like this, and at that pointy place there is no tangent. That's one kind of critical point. And another kind of critical point is when, say, you're still at a maximum location, but the surface is smooth, and at the top here, you have a horizontal tangent. So those are the two kinds of critical point. In either case, it has to do with the partials. So let's compute the partials. The x partial is, well, x cubed over 3, x partial is x squared. And then x squared over 2 is just x, so minus 9x. And then plus 18. And then there's no more x. The y partial is y squared minus 3y minus 10. Okay, these are always defined. These partials are. Which means that all critical points are this variety, the kind where you have horizontal tangency. So that means we need to solve when both partials are zero. Horizontal in the x direction, and also horizontal in the y direction. So we're going to solve x squared minus 9x plus 18 is 0, and I'll call this equation 1, and then y squared minus 3y minus 10 is 0, and I'll call this equation 2. So these equations are interesting. Equation 1 only has x's, and equation 2 only has y's, so we can and must solve them separately. So from equation 1, that's a quadratic that factors. It factors to x minus 3 times x minus 6 equal to 0. So we get 3 or 6 being solutions. And then from equation 2, that also is a quadratic that factors to what? Negative 5 and positive 2. So y plus 2 times y minus 5 is 0. So we get y is negative 2 and y is 5 as solutions. Therefore, when you look at a plot of the input plane, with these x's and these y's, that means that at 3 and 6, if we call these the red solutions, at x is 3, and at x is 6, at those two places, you're horizontal in only the x direction. So this is saying that you're horizontal in the x direction at these places. Okay, but to have a horizontal tangent plane, you need to be horizontal not just in x, but also in y. So taking these green solutions, then at y is negative 2, and at y is 5, this means, they mean, that you're horizontal in the y direction. So to be critical, you have to be horizontal in both x and y direction. So as I was saying, to be critical, to be a critical point, we need both horizontal in x and horizontal in y. Well, that occurs at the intersection. So there's 1, 2, that's horizontal in both x and y, and also here, horizontal in x and also in y. So in fact, there's 4 critical points for this function. So therefore, the critical points are, that is the point 3, 5. This is the point 6, 5. That is the point 3, negative 2. And that is the point 6, negative 2. Okay, so there's 4 critical points, and now we're going to go about classifying each of them. Okay, so we're going to classify. To classify them, we'll need the second partials. So the xx partial is 2x minus 9. The yy partial is 2y minus 3. The mixed partial, xy, that means first x, then y, is 0. And the yx partial, which means first y, then x, is also 0. These are the same, which is good. The mixed partials are the same. Okay, so now we'll classify the point 3, 5. To remind you, the classifier is the product of the pure partials at the point in question. Minus the product of the mixed partials at the point in question. But because the mixed partials are the same, we can just square one of them. So the xx partial at 3, 5. So that's 2 times 3 is 6, minus 9 is negative 3. And then the yy partial at 3, 5 is 2 times 3 is 6, minus 3 is positive 3, and then minus the mixed partials, which are 0 squared, so that's negative, and as a result, that means that the point 3, 5 is a saddle. Okay. Next, 6, 5. Okay, again, the product of the pure partials. So at 6, 5, that's 2 times 6 is 12, minus 9 is positive 3. And then at 5, wait a second, what happened here? So wait, I made an error here. So this here, that should be, because it's y is 5, it's 2 times 5, which is 10, minus 3 is 7. Okay, but it's still negative, so then no change after that. Okay, so at 5 now, 2 times 5 is 10, minus 3 is 7. Okay, good. And then minus 0 squared. Well, this is positive. That means that this point is not a saddle. So it's either a max or a min. And to see which one it is, we can check either pure partial. So at 6, 5, we already did that. That's 3, which is positive. So as a result of those combined, we know that the point 6, 5 is a min. Okay. Now point 3, negative 2. Okay. The classifier is the product of the pure partials. So xx at 3, 2 is 2 times 3 minus 9 is negative 3. And then 2 times negative 2 is negative 4 minus 3 is negative 7. And then minus 0 squared. Well, that's positive 21. So now we can check either the pure partial. So just for fun, because I did xx the previous time, now I'll do yy. So yy at 3, negative 2. Again, we did that right there, so that's negative 7, which is negative. So this means that it's either a max or a min, and this means that it is a max. So the point 3, negative 2 is a max. And then 6, negative 2. The classifier is the product of the pure partials. So the xx partial at 6, negative 2, so that's 2 times 6 is 12 minus 9 is 3. And then the yy partial at 6, negative 2 is negative 7, and then minus 0 squared. Well, that's negative 21, which is negative. So we can conclude that the point 6, negative 2 is a saddle.